wanna be something more. Start afresh.
I started writing the album about 2 years ago. Didn't have like a concept in mind, but all I knew is I wanted it to be really honest and I wanted to be really vulnerable in it. It's kind of like my diary, I guess, of like the big moments that have been going on for me. I wrote most of the album back in Devon, back home. It's just a different pace, and it's a lot of space down there, a lot of nature and peace and quiet, and that just suited me for what I wanted for this. I wanted it to be a really honest account, but musically and sonically I wanted it to be quite spacious. So I just felt like I needed that space to kind of work out what was going on for me. All the songs I wrote myself on the album, I wrote at night. It's definitely my time. It's so peaceful and you feel like you're the only person in the world. At my dad's house, you know, completely cut off. I wrote most of the album between the hours of kind of 8 till 8.
I love the way you smile and how strong you seem to be, but I hate not knowing me. I lose control, dear. Ooh, I love wearing it now, and the future that you planned. But I feel
I was writing up the lyrics for all the songs on the album, and completely unconsciously I had put in control to 80% of the songs. And I kind of had a freak out and thought, oh God, maybe I should change some lyrics. Like, I'm just repeating control over and over again. And then I thought, well, maybe it should be called control, because that's obviously a really key theme of something that I've been dealing with. You know, that it looks at love and friendship and loss and regret and femininity and the pressures around that. The next stage is taking that production and my demos to Dave Okumu and then working them together or giving him some space to work on them. And I felt like that space was like really important. I feel so lucky to have found someone that I really, really trust to be able to do that with. This process, creatively, has like truly taught me what a collaboration is and what trust is.
I was thinking about the first time I heard your music, and I could tell just from hearing like these two little demos that you were someone who actually needed to write music. It wasn't something that you were doing like for like enjoyment or, you know, I don't know, because it was cool or something. I could feel from what I heard that it was something that you needed to do to like understand yourself.
It's funny because like when people ask you about that, they're like, so when did you decide you wanted to do music or that you wanted to write or whatever? And it's like, I didn't really just, and then you do like, very hard to kind of try to express that without sounding like a complete cheese ball. You know, of being like, music's my therapy, or it's like my art is kind of the way that I can kind of find out how I'm feeling about things. But it just is, and it does sound like complete like cheddar cheese, really. On my EP, I feel like Your Baby was me and your ghost, and I feel like this record it was Control.
It will always have such a special place in my heart because, you know, I went to new places through what you'd written, and I felt so free to like do that and just to go on just a completely sort of open creative journey. And like, obviously I was trying to be totally guided by who you are and like what you've expressed, but that didn't feel restrictive at all, and that's what made it actually really fun. Like, it made it really enjoyable to work on those songs. It's like I really sort of treasure that about this music.
My biggest struggle is my self-critic, which is like very present in my life. I put a lot of pressure on myself to be perfect. I think that's really held me back at times. I've got to be really careful about comparing myself. Social media has a big part of that, and I have to stand back from that quite a lot. I got really down about kind of where I was in comparison to other people, and you know, you just can't create putting my emotions into music, not looking at what other people are doing. That's just been really, really key for me. And just focus on what I'm doing, my own thing, because otherwise you can get lost in everyone else, and then what you're creating isn't really you. It's just trying to fit into this kind of box that everyone else is putting you in. Well, I'm so excited about getting this out, and I just wasn't interested in rushing this process because it's my debut, and you know, it's so important that I am proud of this, and I've made the best thing that I can make for this point in my life.
Oh, I think that might be nice.
It's too painful to even think about. so it would kill me to say it out loud.
I guess I felt like, in many ways, the music was begging to be called Control. It's really funny because when people say, like, in what way, like, gaining control, but it's never been that. For me, it was more about kind of trying to relinquish control. And I guess I thought that control and strength went hand in hand, and I've learned through this process very much so that it's not always that way. And actually half of the battle is being letting go of control and just putting my trust into people and just letting things be, which is something that I find really hard to do. And yeah, if a few people can relate to it, then that's like golden to me, yeah.
Never know.